Greetings. Good afternoon. I guess it's good afternoon. This is Brother Wes, and I just want to encourage someone real quick, real briefly. I want to encourage someone who's struggling. I want to encourage someone who's going through troubles. Well, I want to encourage someone who's going through tough times, and I just want to let you know that there's tomorrow. The Bible says that weeping may endure for a night. You might be in your nighttime right now, and things might be hard, things might be difficult, but their joy will come in the morning. And the only thing you have to do from the weeping and may endure for a night to the morning time, wait and trust God in the place, in the condition, in the mindset, what you're facing, what you're fighting, what you're dealing with. Keep trusting and keep believing God, and God will bring you through out of that situation. You might be in a marital situation that might be bad, and it might look like it might be even over. But let me let you know something, that God is not over until God says it's over. It's just like even with the Bible talks about even Lazarus. Lazarus was dead 4 days and people thought it was over. But Jesus was there, and Jesus walked upon the scene and stood at his tomb and said, come forth. You might be in a marriage where it seems like it might be over, but God says not over. All you got to do is give it to God. All you got to do. You might be praying for a certain person. You might be praying for a certain situation, and it seems like you keep praying, but it seems like the situation is still the same. Keep praying and keep trusting God. Matter of fact, even fast, throw a little fast on in that too. See, because God is faithful. He's faithful to answer us. See, God is not slack concerning his promises, because he said that he's going to do it. And if it doesn't happen, it's something that we did. It's something that we did that blocked it. See, but God want to give it to you. God want to bless you. God want to give you the fat of the land. God want to give you the fatted calf. God want to give you, the Bible said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and the world and they that dwell therein. See, so God wants to give you everything. God wants you to be happy. God don't want you to live in poverty. God don't want you to live in shame. And God don't want you to live in being down or feeling in a place where you feel like you're hurt. You feel like you're useless. You feel like you're unwanted. You feel like no one loves you. God loves you. The Bible said God so loved the world, John 3:16, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever should believe on him should not perish but have everlasting life. For some of you that listen to me, that will listen to me, and that you're backslidden and you went back on God, but you want to go back. God been talking to you. He been talking to you to come back. He been talking to you. He been pulling on your heart, saying, pray to me again. Cry out to me again. Sing to him again. You know what God is doing. Some of you that God has been calling you to come on back. Come on back. Come on back to God. See, because God didn't hurt you. God want to love you again. God want to show you everything. God want to show you his choices, blessings. God want to show you the cattle on the thousand hill. God want to show you his mysteries. God wants you to love, and God wants you to be happy. Some of you feel like you'll never have happiness. It seems like happiness has escaped you. God wants you to be happy. God wants you to be happy. But the thing that you must realize, you cannot be desperate. You cannot be desperate. Trust God, because what you need to realize, for those of you that are praying for a man, for those of you that are praying for a woman to marry, someone to grow old with, oftentimes, anytime before the authentic come, the counterfeit will come. The adversary will sin and counterfeit. So that's why your eyes must be aware of the adversary. And you have to also put your flesh or your emotions in check. You know what you want. You know what you desire. But don't put your wants and your desires before God. Or don't put your wants and your desires before what God wants. See, because God is going to show you him. God is going to show you her. And for that person that's in that relationship, that's not married, that you're in a bad situation and you want to get out, God wants you to get out. Get out. Stop thinking about the consequences. Stop thinking about money. Stop thinking about that person. But think about you. Think about God. See, some of you, and the person that listens to me right now, your blessing is when you leave. Your blessing is when you walk away. See, because when you walk away from a bad situation, God's going to walk you into something that's good. God's going to walk you into something that's joyous and plenteous, something that's worth it. What you must realize, and I'm about to close, is that oftentimes we go through situations. The Bible said we go from faith to faith and glory to glory. And oftentimes the things that we suffer, even in relationships, even bad relationships, it prepares us for the next relationship. So what you failed in that one, but your failure in that one is going to prepare you for the next one. You didn't appreciate him. You didn't appreciate her in the last relationship. But in this new relationship, you're going to appreciate him because you know what it takes. And so I'm just talking. I just want to encourage you in the Lord. And I want you to lift up and lift your heads up. Lift your heads up for those of you that feel like the weight of the world is upon you. It feels like everything is coming at you at the same time. I just want to let you know. And it feels it's unbearable. And you've been crying to God and saying, God, with how long? God, how long am I going to be in this condition? How long am I going to be in this same situation? How long am I going to be in this same situation? This same step, this same place. You're tired of it. But God says, stand right up. See, God is going to bring you out of it, but God wants you to be patient. See, because in the place where you're standing, what God is doing, God is changing you. God is growing you. God is expanding you. See, faith, see, the thing about it, faith, when faith is activated, faith is going to be tried. When you say that you want patience, when you cry and say, God, give me patience, God, give me wisdom and all that, you know what you're asking for? You're asking for troubles. You're asking for rejections. You're asking for hurts. See, but it's in those hurts and those rejections that's going to give you, that's going to birth that patience out. That's going to birth that wisdom out. That's going to birth that love out. And so God is preparing you. So, but what we must do and what you must do in this place, in this state of mind, think clear. God wants you to think clear. In adverse conditions, think clear. See, because when you rush, when things are going crazy all around you, when you rush to try to rectify it, then that's when you make a mistake. Don't rush. Set back and take a breath. And see, some of you, and I'm done after this right here. Some of you, you're in a place, you're in a valid decision, you're trying to figure out things. You're trying to figure out who's for you, who's against you. You're trying to figure out your heart because you've been hurt, but now you're back. And you rededicated yourself to God. You rededicated yourself to holiness. You rededicated yourself to doing what's right. And so now you're trying to figure out things. You're trying to position yourself and see who's for you and who's against you. God said, trust me. Trust me. And I will give you the answer. And I will show you who's for you and who's against you. You have a good day. God bless you. Listen and share. Have a good day.